If you're a subscriber to this channel, I sure do appreciate it. If not, I hope you consider doing so. And don't forget to give the video a thumbs up. Hey everybody, it's John, one side of a two-car garage in the Upper East Side of Texas, and as promised in this video, we're going to lay out the bolt pattern for the head. Now, I had said previously that I prefer odd number bolt patterns, and really I do, but then I went back and I looked at the bolt pattern on this particular engine, and it was a 6 bolt pattern in the head, and I got to looking at it and said, you know, that doesn't look too bad. So that's what I'm going to go with, is go right by the plans. Now, one thing that I also mentioned was that I have 2 dividing heads. I've got a 6-inch and an 8-inch, and I do use those dividing heads for certain applications. However, in over 25 years of building steam engines and model gasoline engines, I've never used a dividing head to lay out bolt patterns in a circle. You can use a dividing head. You can use a milling machine with a direct with a digital readout. I don't have a digital readout, so I don't use that. What I use the method that machinists have been using for centuries, and that is a dividing head and just simple high school geometry. And I'm going to show you how to do that. And when I get through, it's going to look good. I may be off 1/1000th of an inch. Again, I'm not building interchangeable heads, so it's a non-issue. I'm making this head to fit that particular engine. And by the time I get this done, you won't even have your dividing head set up. Let's go to the lathe, then back to the workbench, and let's use some good old high school geometry. Okay, I've already got everything chucked up in the lathe, and I'm gonna use the Mark-A-Lot, and I'm just using the collet that I had used the other day. And what I'm gonna do is, I have got a tool that's got a very sharp point on it, and it's ground to where the point is on the right side or right hand side of it. I'm just going to put this in like this, and what I'll do is come to the outside, and I'm going to get the outside edge of this. Essentially what I'm going to be doing here is measuring the distance between this outside lip here and this inside boss that's there. So what I'll do is just come to the outside and move in till I just touch that. And I'm gonna show you an old machinist trick right here. When you're trying to sneak up on something, this is cigarette paper, and they're gonna look at you funny when you go by this, but if you're my age, they'll either think you're a pot-smoking old man or I'm still rolling my own. Well, none of those are the case, but cigarette paper is a good thing to keep around the home shop for measuring. And what I'm going to do is just put this cigarette paper, because it tears so easy, and just put the cigarette paper between the work and whatever you're trying to do, and just keep moving that up and down until it catches. And right there's where it caught. So go ahead, I'm going to zero my dial. Now I can back out to where zero is, come back, and now I'm going to go into where this part here is. So there was my zero, so I'm starting off there. So I'm just going to wind in. There's 100 thousandths. There's 200 thousandths. It's 201 thousandths. So I'm going to go in 100 thousandths, back out, come back in zero. Now go in 100 thousandths. And then I'm just going to come in and just scrape. All I want to do is just scrape. I don't want to make very much of a mark, but that's what that tool right there is doing. And I'm just going to move in until I can barely get a line on it, which I have. Now, I've got my line marked. Now I'm going to go back over to the desk, to the workbench, and I'll show you what we're going to be doing next as far as laying out the hole pattern. All right, I'm back at the workbench, and I've zoomed in a little bit, and I'm not real sure how well you're going to be able to see that line, but I'll try to move it a couple of different ways, and maybe you can see that little scribe mark that I had made initially. So I brought the collet back over here, the little homemade collet, and that's to get it nice and solid, so when I prick it with a prick punch, I'll be able to do that. Now, I'm going to go off camera because I got to get my head right down on it with my optimizer, because I want to punch right on that little line. Now, the good thing is when you scribe the line with a two-bit like that, and you go in, oh, I don't know, half a thousandth or so, you can actually feel that line with your prick punch. And I like that because I'll always know I'm right on that particular line. So I'm going to take it off, and I'm going to prick or punch right on that line using the optimizer, and then I'll be right back. All right, so you can see the one prick punch that I have. Now, these are called dividers, and there's a reason they're called dividers. The reason they're called dividers is because you can divide a line. For example, if I have a line that's 3 inches long or so, I can divide it into three equal pieces by moving the divider in and out. That's what I'm going to do here. Now, as I said before, you can use the dividing head, and by all means, if you want to get that accurate, please do so. This, I'm not telling you how to build your engine. I know this is not the most accurate way, but it's certainly the most accurate way for me. For the time given in here, I have never used a dividing head on any cylinder head that I've ever built, and that includes IC engines or internal combustion engines, steam engines, and over about 20 years of doing this, this seems to work really well. Now, what you're going to do is, if you choose this method here, you're going to use the dividers to just walk around that line. You're not making any marks, you're just walking around that line. And I'm going to just walk over here. And again, you can feel where that line is. Get that one, bring that on around. You always want to keep one leg of your divider always down. And six, I'm just a little bit off, a little bit shy. I'm going to move it out just a little bit, and what you do is you either move these points in or out. For example, if I had seven, if it took me seven to go around before I did that, my jaws were too close together. If I had done it in four, they're too far apart. So that's the reason you only have that one prick punch. That's always your starting point, and I'm going to walk around again. Now I've got everything. One thing when on that final marking, what I do is when I get to this one, I actually press it down just a little bit and use the point of that divider to shove it in the brass a little bit or aluminum. And actually, you can even do that in steel. All you need is just something to help solidify that. Now that I've got this marked, and in essence, what I've done here as I walked around that cylinder head, I know this is the cylinder itself here. Here was my cylinder head, like this. Then I took it to the lathe, and here's the line that I scribed around there. And of course, here was my boss that was on the inside. Took a prick punch, punched right there, then walked. And each time I did that, you walk and then you turn them over. In other words, I was doing this right here to here. And then, you give that a swipe. So you'll have one that goes right there. Then you turn this one right here. Then you'll give that one a swipe and so forth. And you'll end up right back where you started at on that drawing. Again, a dividing head would be accurate. And with a dividing head, you'd be able to take this whenever it's built. At that point, with a dividing head, if you choose to do that much accuracy, which would mean that you could then put this cylinder head on that way, turn it, put it back on that way, all the bolt holes would match. Mine, may or may not match. I may be off a thousandth either way. But again, this is the engine I'm building. You choose to build yours the way that you want to do it. I know a lot of people leave the comments about, there's a much more accurate way. I absolutely know there is, but this works well for steam engines. Again, not saying that whatever you do is what you want to do on your engine, but this is the way that works really well for me. Now, the next thing is to go ahead and get the little prick punch and go ahead and get everything marked. And again, as I've said before, I use several stages in these punches. Usually the first thing I do, even though physically this is a bigger punch, it's got a very, very fine point on it. And I keep that point very fine, and just razor sharp. It's almost like a needle. Then I go to this punch right here, which is an old Stuart punch. It makes a little bit bigger hole, and a lot of times that's where I stop. But if I need to really drive something home, then I come in with this punch right here. But you don't start with those big punches. You start with those little ones. In fact, I can take this one, and I actually need to take it over and sharpen it one more time. But a lot of times with it, I'll just turn it over and just push down, and it's sharp enough to make that indent, and then come back on the second one with this little punch right here, and then drill my holes. So that's how you do a layout on the head, and I'll be back on the next section, holes drilled, and we're going to go ahead and put it into the cylinder. I'll show you how to transfer your holes over to it. Until we meet again on the next video, this is John from one side of a two-car garage in the great state of Texas. We're going to see you on the next video. Don't forget to subscribe, share, and give it a thumbs up. Thanks a lot, guys.